My talk is about free software and free culture. Making music with GNU Linux. My name is Tobias Platen. I'm a fellow of the Fellowship of the Free Software Foundation Europe. And first I'll explain what free software is. Free software is software that comes with four freedoms. The first freedom is the freedom to use the software for any purpose. The second freedom is the freedom to study the work and make changes. The third freedom is the freedom to distribute the work to others. And the fourth freedom is the freedom to distribute modified works. If one of those freedoms is missing, the software is non-free. And freedom requires that you have access to the source code of the software. But that's not enough. There are threats like typization. This is the contrast to open source. And there's already the phenomenon of free culture and open source culture. And there's a difference. If something is open source, it is not really free. And in Alex Leavitt's book about open source culture, he discusses the mass multimedia sharing phenomenon that has built around Hatsune Miku. She is a Japanese pop star, actually a singing synthesis instrument that is used as a new musical instrument, but the software itself is not free. But those media sharing appears in a way that is similar to free. And with free culture, you have several freedoms, and media companies try to restrict what you can. For example, Vocaloid restricts that you cannot use the sound samples with your own synthesizer. And with free culture, you have that freedom. You can change the sound samples. Now I go to how do you make music with GNU Linux. There are special audio distributions for GNU Linux. Some of them are fully free. Then you need recording hardware that works with your ALSA kernel. And not every kind of hardware is supported on GNU Linux, but many class-compliant devices are. This recording hardware can be a microphone or a MIDI keyboard. And if you have the hardware, you need to understand how to use the software. On GNU Linux, there is a sound system called Jack, which allows you to interconnect multiple applications and control them with a single transport. To make actual sound, if you don't use physical instruments, you need synthesizers or samplers. And there are many free synthesizers and samplers available. Once you have that, you can produce your music. I'll explain later how this is done. And once the music is composed, you can post-process the music using different plugins such as LV2, where one can change, can add effects as, such as reverb or equalizing voices. And in the last step, one can export the song as a WAV file or as an ogg vorbis and upload to the internet. Digital music has source code-like software, and there are several ways how software can be distributed. For example, or music in source code can be distributed. Lilypond is a notation program which allows you to enter text and get musical notations. MIDI is a format that is used by hardware music synthesizers as well as by software. And Lilypond can export MIDI. There is also Music XML, which is a new XML format, which maps all features that can be used in graphical and musical notation. For blind musicians is Braille, which also has software support. And then there is the classical printed sheet music, which also acts as a human-readable source code. It can be transcribed in many other formats. For singing synthesis, there are special formats, like the VSQ format from Vocaloid, which is available is an XML format. It is a proprietary music source code format. The UST from Utau, which is similar, and recently I started implementing a JSON-based format for monophonic music synthesis. And these formats can be used to create waveforms, which are actually not source code, except when you record directly from a physical instrument, then there is source audio, which can be processed using different plugins. When you start making music, the first step is that you compose the music using MIDI, because MIDI is that most programs do understand. MIDI is the common source code for digital music, which was invented about 30 years ago, and it can be used to modify musical pieces. If you have only an MP3, you cannot do modifications as easily as you can with a MIDI. The MIDI format is an open standard by digital instrument makers. For example, Yamaha keyboards have a floppy disk drive, or had a floppy disk drive 10 years ago. Modern keyboards have USB stick support, and these keyboards can actually save performances on a floppy disk and then replay the performance. The sheet music can be typeset with Lilypond. Once you have a MIDI, you can use MIDI editors such as Rosegarden to export Lilypond. And in Rosegarden, you can also do graphical note input, either using piano roll or the classical musical score. And you can use keyboards as an input, but then you have to quantize the notes. And there are also plugins that can manipulate MIDI data with LV2, so you can build an arpeggiator or some other MIDI effects. You can create background chords on your detected melody. And those MIDI files are small, they fit on a floppy disk and can be easily shared through the internet. This is an example of such a MIDI-based audio workstation where you can compose songs. In this case, it does not detect the correct scale. And in MIDI, this, you cannot really specify this in a good way. This is one problem of MIDI music format. And but you can manually select a scale for a segment, and then you get these gray lines, which are used for the chord of the first tone of your scale. Once you have composed a melody, you will to create an audio data, or while composing, this is actually played live if you run the plugin. And there are different ways to do this. With the MIDI format, the MIDI format controls hardware and software sound generators. And two examples of these sound generators that I often use are Qsynth, that is a sound font based sampler. Sound font is an industry standard for instrument sounds. And with ZyNetFX you have more synthetic sounds. It has an FM synthesizer, it can create organ sound. The pad synth is a special algorithm for creating pad sounds. And this is event-based control. So when you press a key on the keyboard, an event is sent to the synthesizer and the sound is created. And the most important MIDI messages are node on, node off, and modulation. So you can change the pitch with the wheel. There are special controller events, such as a sustain pedal and a portamento time that you can specify. And there are special MIDI instruments like laptop keyboards, which can be configured with SysX messages. You can also use SysX messages to transfer new sound fonts to hardware instruments. Here, these are two examples. The first is the Qsynth. It has a built-in effects rack where you can specify reverb and chorus, but only globally, not per channel. And the second one is ZyNetDubFX, which is a more complex synthesizer where one can configure different sounds and create your own instruments very easily. When you want to mix different instruments, so you can change loudness for different instruments and add special effects such as a compressor. For example, if one instrument is not very loud and you don't want to make the instrument globally louder, then you can use a compressor. You should always add a reverb to voices. And this has a built-in mixer. It supports both MIDI and audio tracks. For MIDI tracks, you always need to instantiate a synthesizer. And this is Arduino. This allows you to use the track transport. So when you click play, other sequencer applications will also play. And one of these other applications is Hydrogen. Hydrogen is a drum computer. And those programs are synchronized, they have a common time base, and with those two and a program which allows you to compose MIDIs, you can actually compose songs. What I also do is using the singing synthesis that is also very popular in Japan, and most programs that allow singing synthesis are non-free. Therefore, I began writing a free replacement in 2011, and at the current time, I have a working tech demo, also an internet page where one can upload a MIDI file and get a singing synthesis example. The program supports both German and English singing. It is derived from the free software speech synthesizer eSpeak. And once you have that, you can master your music and mix all together. Therefore, you should use an integrated DAWs that support plugins. I already mentioned it. For each singer, you usually use a chorus and a reverb, but also for many other instruments. A feedback delay line produces an echo effect. This is often used for guitars. You can use tube amplifier emulation. Compressors can be used to change the dynamics, and there are already those CAV plugins. Those provide graphical equalizers and much more. And if you want to have a Kraftwerk sound like, you should use vocoders. So you can mix an instrument signal with a voice. And in the last step, I'll explain how one can publish the music. SoundCloud is very popular, but I don't use it because it uses non-free JavaScript. I have my own Media Goblin instance. There are also public Media Goblin instances where one can make songs available to the public. You can sell self-burned CDs to your fanbase. For example, many Vocaloid producers sell their CDs at anime conventions. And this is a least restrictive way compared to ways such as iTunes, which only works on non-free operating systems and requires non-free EULAs. And additionally, you can use FLAC or OcVorbis if you distribute the music online through a different channel and not iTunes. FLAC is, for example, supported by CD Baby. And you can also allow remixes by publishing source code, for example, MIDI and USTJ. Many UTAO producers do this already. And currently, there is a new payment system in development called Gnutala, which could be also used by a music store that allows anonymous payments, and you get then a FLAC file for download. And last but not least, there is already a Verwertungsgesellschaft under German law called the C3S, which tries to make fund free culture. And This is because of GEMA is doing censorship on the internet. And we don't want censorship, and we want ways that people who create free culture can be also supported financially. This is now the end of my talk. And you can now ask. Yes? Yes, I have many songs on my hard disk. So this character here is Hatsune Miku, which I showed again. She was created by Krypton Future Media. And I can demonstrate some songs, yes. This is a song that was created, that I found at the site of the Free Software Foundation. This is a synthesizer that was written by a person from Germany, and I'm currently working on improving the synthesizer.
Was this eSpeak?
This was eSpeak, yes. Oh, cool. And there is already VConnect, that is a Japanese synthesizer that is less known here in Germany. And this one actually uses recorded sounds and changes the pitch and the length of segments and concatenates the segments. And it has been released under GNU General Public License version 3. It originally ran only on Windows. I took the program and ported it to GNU Linux. And now I'm going to publish the package on mentors.debian.net so that anybody can install the program. And the program internally uses the Vorbis format, to compress the residual part of the sound. It uses a speech analysis framework which detects the fundamental frequency, then it detects the spectral envelope, and there is a third component that is called the residual, and that part can be only compressed using Vorbis, because other compression formats for sound that are commonly used don't include the phase of the sound, and that can be done if you use Vorbis. And in the new version, aperiodicity is instead used, and you don't need the Vorbis format, which was actually not designed for speech synthesis. And 1 week ago, I experimented with the new version of the software, and I found out that this way also compresses the speech from the PCM to half of the size, but you don't get the same speech waveforms, and it sounds nearly similar to the original sound. You create a MIDI file with RoseGarden. I can demonstrate it. And then you can upload. There is a lyrics editor. You export a MIDI file. And then Then you send this to the page. This may take time. And when it has been synthesized, then the page returns and you get a download link. And it should work for with MIDI files that you have created with Rose Garden. And you can also use eSpeak's phonetic notation, especially if you use English words. Oh, my server has crashed. I can't fix that problem. Currently, I have to look into my log files and find out why it did not work. But I had tested it last week and it had worked at the time.
Is the server public?
The software is public, yes. It is published on GitHub.
Your private server, and it's not publicly on the web.
That it is public on the web. And if it doesn't work, you can complain to the webmaster of the server. I'll add an email link where one can complain if something doesn't work. And the other thing, we connect stand, that is also published, but its documentation is only in Japanese. So there is much more work to do to make the software actually usable. The site is actually ekanterix.moe. Moe is a Japanese term that is a new domain that was recently added to the domain name system, and you can register such domains. But I have found that somebody has used the Embrolla synthesizer for singing, but Embrolla itself is non-free, and I think it is time that one builds a free replacement, which also requires building voice banks, and that is the much harder part than building the synthesis software alone. For singing synthesis, yes. For example, for the original. This voice is Hatsune Miku. She is sold by Krypton Future Media. This one is by Hatsune Miku, and on YouTube there is a V-Connect version which was covered, but instead free software was used for singing synthesis. And it sounds really similar to Vocaloid. But unfortunately, this free software only supports Japanese. It is not actively maintained anymore. And it's much more work to support other languages, as Japanese is quite easy to support in a singing synthesizer. And for European languages, you have to currently use eSpeak, or at least the eSpeak front end, which needs to be refactored if you use a different backend synthesis engine. And there are some more people working on Vocaloid replacements that they have released and as free software, but most of them only support Japanese and Chinese, as those engines are UTAO compatible, and I'm currently doing something that is more powerful.
What's the name of your program?
My is QTAO, which I actually maintain. That is the graphical editor. I can demonstrate my editor. I don't know if it starts if the jack sound system is not running. No, I have to start jack first. And here you can draw notes. Enter lyrics. And you get a phonetic transcription. This is already done. So it supports English. You can also switch to other languages supported by eSpeak, and it works in most cases when a word has multiple syllables, but in sometimes it fails and you have to specify manually the phonetic transcription, which is a bit hard, then you need to read the eSpeak. And I did not publish this version yet. There are too many bugs I want to fix, and when I have fixed them, I maybe will release the program. It doesn't save MIDI, it uses its own JSON format, but it can import and export MIDI. It uses UTOW JSON sequence text files. It originally used the UTOW format, but that format is not extensible, not well documented, so I defined a new JSON format, which is easy to understand and actually Qt has its own JSON parser, and parsing UST files, that is a text-based format, actually a modified Windows INI, that does not work very well. And it seems that QTOW is already connected. And it should also produce a sound if I click play. It first renders the sounds. Takes a little bit when you do this first, but once a note is cached, it will be. Also, das war hier doch noch ein bisschen. It seems to be a little bit buggy. I made a mistake, but it worked perfectly some weeks or months ago before I went to Anime Marathon. And after that, I changed the format to JSON. And now it seems to produce invalid MIDI files. As eSpeak has special formats for its format. So I don't plan to release the program until most bugs are fixed and it has been tested. And some complete songs have been produced. Then I'll do a release.